So, good afternoon, everybody. And today we have with us Nishita Mantri. I think the only women business coach who is coaching women solopreneurs. And, you know, she was invited by Narendra Modi for the Startup India initiative in January 2016. Where she was amongst the few women who shared the platform to represent the voice of an Indian women entrepreneur. So hats off to Nishita, and let me give her a brief introduction. Welcome Nishita first to CAFE, and we are a group of 400 women entrepreneurs and aspiring entrepreneurs also. And you know, today's session with you will definitely be very, very helpful to each of us, whether we are planning to start or we are already into business and planning to grow. Because yes, I have seen some of your past videos and they were really very helpful. So welcome to CAFE, Nishita. And let me give a brief introduction of Nishita's. Nishita is a business coach for women solopreneurs. She consults women on how to launch their business and get to their first customer. She helps women design their business plan and evaluate their revenue model as to how they can scale their business and make it profitable. She has a unique way of mentoring where she calls her program a mini MBA for startups, in which she educates women on marketing strategies and increasing sales through her thought worksheets. She's also authored two books, which also includes her worksheet books, which is really helpful. And over the past years, Nishita has helped 300 plus brands to launch, more than 500 women startups to launch, 2,500 women entrepreneurs she has trained, and she has mentored more than 1,000 businesses. So today we are looking forward to have a very, very exciting session with Nishita on how we can create a business which does not fail. So Nishita, welcome to CAFE, and we look forward to have an amazing session with you.
Thank you so much, Kavita, for an interesting, exciting introduction. You know, when you hear about yourself, every introduction you feel finally, there's something that I've achieved. You know, ek acha reminder aa jata hai apne achievement ka. So guys, whenever you're feeling low and down in business, get somebody to introduce you. It really motivates you.
Very, very true, actually.
Yeah. So guys, the reason I picked this topic with Kavita for, you know, conducting all of y'all is that most of us fear failure. And most of us do not take the necessary actions, the necessary decisions, not just in business, but also in life, because of the fear of failing. You know, so this has been a very, very, very big issue that people have, you know, when they want to start a business and also grow the business. Okay. You know, Kavita, if you could just tell me that most of these women here, are they already in business or are they someone who want to start a business? Because I would want to, you know, keep my flow in that direction.
Absolutely. So can everybody please type in the chat box? Most of them are already into business.
Great. So that's my favorite crowd. You know, when you're already in the business, you understand what I'm saying even better. Okay. So let's first, you know, discuss what about your business you're failing. You know, if you could just put it in the chat for me, that what part of your business you're failing, because the topic is very clear. What can you do so that your business never fails? So, you know, let's first get some awareness, some clarity of what in your business is failing for you. You know, what's not working out. Okay, great marketing. I'm just going to read a couple of them. Marketing, target audience. Okay, reaching target audience, marketing. I think majorly everybody stuck with marketing and promoting their business. Great. Wow. So I'm going to definitely address this first so that you all have some way of what you can do for your marketing. You know, I love to call myself as a business coach for women solopreneurs, because I feel that, you know, women always are a one-man army. Even if it's running the house, raising the children, doing anything, they're a one-man army. We can do anything without anybody. Even if we don't have maids, we can do everything. It's not how men can do, you know. If they don't have a pune in the office, they cannot do the running around.
Sure.
So, you know, that's a really big difference. So let me see, let me give you an example of how and why I became a business coach for women solopreneurs and what I really come bring on the table for women. Okay, so if marketing is your concern, which most of you all have mentioned here, let me just pick this up and give you a very straightforward solution to this. Okay, guys, understand you are low on budget. You don't have time. You don't have a big team. You're not a corporate. So you have a lot of restrictions and still you want to make at least 1 crore every year. Okay. It's totally doable. With the whole digital media and social media and everything coming in place, it's totally doable. Okay. Now, how you do it? How do you create that marketing? Okay. I call something as a game changer strategy. Okay. If you all have a pen and a paper, just make this a note. It's something that I created specifically for women, and I call it as the game changer strategy. I want you to sit for 30 minutes over a cup of tea, akele, go to a place, your favorite cafe, reward yourself a cup of coffee or tea, sit for 30 minutes and, you know, Chris, socho. How this works is, you know, I'll give you my own example. You know, when I was starting out, so in 2009, I started running an advertising and a marketing agency in Bombay. Okay, born, brought up, raised in Bombay. I had just finished my master's from the UK and I thought that meko apna khud ka kuch karna hai. Let me do something. So I started running an advertising agency, which was, you know, a marketing and a branding consulting firm. And from there, I made this, you know, a shift of just doing marketing, branding and sales for women entrepreneurs and tagged myself as a business coach. Okay. Now, when I became a business coach, it was very difficult, one, to get people to pay me, to get people to believe in me. You know, even if you're selling chocolates or cakes, you want people to believe in you, you know, and then to get people to actually trust me, you know, with their business, because service, nothing is tangible. You know, if you're making an outfit, the outfit can say that it's pretty and I want it, but service is really not possible. So I sat down and I started thinking, how can people trust me? So your first question for marketing should be, how can people trust you? What can you do to increase the trust? You know, so in my business, I figured out, first question, how will people trust me? How can I get, you know, so there are two questions here, how to reach to a target audience, you know, and then how can people, you know, pay you marketing? So both of this is here. One, how can people trust me? Where can I find these people? And as a business coach, I was very clear in my head, mujhe free ka kuch nahi karna hai. Because as a coach, in my mind, it was very clear that if you give certain, you know, something for free, then people don't come back to you and pay for something. They utte mein khush ho jate ki bhai itna de diya na free mein bas ho gaya abhi mera, I'm good. So they will not pay me. It was a mental block that I had. So I was very clear, mujhe kuch bhi free ka nahi karna hai. First thing. Second mental block that I had was because I was seeing a lot of other coaches doing free seminars, free sessions, free webinars, lot of free stuff, but their strategy was free mein bulao aur fir kuch ek bada sa 2-5 lakh ka product bech do. And I was very clear, mujhe wo bhi nahi karna. I don't want people to come and say, oh, ye to bechne kuch bulaya. I wanted to give pure knowledge. So I started thinking, what can I do, you know, because my problem is I don't I didn't want to put my time and something into something and not get paid for it. So, you know, that way. So what I did was, I thought, if people have to trust me, they have to hear me. They have to listen to me. only then they can believe me, only then they'll trust me, only then they will be willing to pay me, you know. So what I did, I thought I can't do free sessions and talks, right? Let me create a YouTube channel. And through my YouTube channel, I will do free 5 minutes, 7 minutes videos, which will be general, which will not only give people, you know, get to hear me for free, give out some content for free, but also YouTube will help me in marketing. You know, people search on it, people search on Google. So it was a very holistic plan. That through doing videos and through talking, I'm going to make sure that, you know, I reach a lot of people, audience, marketing, everything is in place. Now, this one thought of doing a YouTube channel was my game changer strategy. Trust me, you don't have to do everything. You know, today I can do Facebook, Instagrams, you know, website, SEO. I can do LinkedIn. There's so much. I mean, आप खुद सोचते हो कि अगर ये करूंगी तो मैं एक्चुअल प्रोडक्ट कब बनाऊंगी और एक्चुअली इसको बेचूंगी कब. आई एम श्योर दिस इज अ प्रॉब्लम विद एवरीबडी. सो डोंट ट्राई टू डू एवरीथिंग. डू वन थिंग. यू कैन मे बी जस्ट पिक वन प्लेटफॉर्म एंड जस्ट फोकस ऑन दैट प्लेटफॉर्म एंड दैट वन थिंग दैट यू डू. सो इनिशियली एंड आई विल टेल यू हाउ दिस वर्क्ड फॉर मी. इनिशियली इफ समबडी हैड टू कॉल मी and you know check for my consultation charges or programs or whatever, it would take me 45 minutes 30 to 45 minutes on a call to explain them what it is all about and how much it will be priced at. And that 45 minutes of, you know, a lot of stuff jisme I'm sure if there are coaches here, you end up giving them the plan only. You know, aapke muh se wo free mein sab nikal hi jata hai and the other person is like, wow, thank you so much, and goes tata bye bye. And I was like, yeah, this is happening, you know. And it was like 200 calls. I'm doing 30, 45 minutes. And out of that, 10, 15 people are registering. You know, it was too time consuming. So with these videos coming in place, what happened is those 30 minute to 45 minutes call came down to 7 minutes. Because they had already heard a couple of my videos. They already knew who I am. They already knew the credibility I had. They already had the trust. You know, we call it the KLT formula for business. Know, like, and trust. K stands for know, L stands for like, and T stands for trust. KLT formula. So when somebody starts working with me, I first tell them, let's create your KLT formula. How are people getting to know about you? You know, if I ask you today in your business a simple question, India mein aapke business ka naam ya aap kya karte ho, give me in numbers kitne logo ko pata hai. You know that it's at the fingertip. Kyare, looking for a baker in Kolkata. Oh, I know her. How many such people do you know? They know you. It's not like they are acquainted to you. They know you. You might not have more than 50-100 people. And that is the target audience. That is what your know has to be about. That can you get a lot of people to know you? That, you know, the minute, you know, your category of business is, you know, mentioned, then take your name. You know, the recall is very high. So that was the whole thing. And then I got people to give me 7 minutes and then start enrolling for sessions. So this, in short, is your game changer strategy. Find out that one thing that you can do in your business regularly, consistently, constantly, you know, every day, 15 minutes you can give to this, and then you're sorted. So my videos were doing well, but then I realized that only YouTube is not going to work. So then I started doing a lot of videos on Instagram. I started doing lives on Instagram. I started doing reels on Instagram. But understand, the core was for me, people to know, like, and trust me, they have to hear me. All these webinars, these Zoom calls, all everything in my marketing plan is only around the point I want more and more people to hear me. So this will give you some relief. Okay, what can you do in your business? One thing, you can be creative with that and you make your own marketing plan. Guys, marketing plan can be as simple as this. You don't really need to do 100 things. When you have team budgets, then obviously things change. But as a starting point, if you're stuck in your current business, this is the first thing you can do. Okay. Today, the idea was that what can you do in your business so that it does not fail? You know, I'm going to be sharing with you 12 business fundamentals that you need to have in your business, absolutely well planned, so that your business does not fail. Okay, so these 12 fundamentals are derived from a lean canvas model. It is basically by the Boston Consulting Group. They create a business canvas model, which is for corporates and bigger businesses. They've also created a smaller version of that, which is called the lean canvas model, in which they say that if you are someone in business, you know, and their research says that 8 out of 10 people, you know, who run business fail, that business fails. 8 out of 10 businesses fail. And when I say fail, it means either you're running in losses or you're shut, or आप 5 साल से वही गोल गोल घूम रहे हो. यू रियली नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग, यू नो, यू आर नॉट स्केलिंग अप. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ अस, आई कैन बेट माई लाइफ, आर जस्ट डूइंग द सेम थिंग फॉर द लास्ट 5 years. सेम रेवेन्यू, सेम क्लाइंट, सेम प्रोडक्ट, एवरीथिंग सेम. नो स्केलेबिलिटी. यू नो, यू कांट से दैट आई हैड अ टीम ऑफ 5, नाउ आई हैव अ टीम ऑफ 50. दैट्स रेयर. सो डोंट कॉल दिस एज बिजनेस. दिस इज जस्ट योर सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड. दिस इज नॉट बिजनेस. ओके. So the lean canvas model said that if you want to really call that you are in business, the first thing you need to do and have is a business plan. Okay. Now there are these 12 elements and fundamentals that you need to have it ready in your business plan. Okay. The first fundamental of making sure your business does not fail is addressing the problem that you're solving. You know, आपके बिजनेस में ऐसा क्या प्रॉब्लम है जो आप सॉल्व कर रहे हो? राइट दैट डाउन, यू नो, फिगर दैट आउट. व्हाट प्रॉब्लम एम आई सॉल्विंग थ्रू माय बिजनेस? यू नो, एंड इट कुड बी एवरी बिजनेस. देयर कुड बी प्रॉब्लम्स विद एवरी बिजनेस दैट योर बिजनेस इज सॉल्विंग. यू नो, आई कुड से दैट आई एम अ बिजनेस कोच एंड आई एम गोइंग टू हेल्प वुमेन, यू नो, स्टार्ट देयर बिजनेस एंड ग्रो देयर बिजनेस. लेकिन उन वुमेन को चाहिए ही नहीं है प्रोडक्ट. लोग बोलते हैं हमको चाहिए ही नहीं है. कुछ तो प्रॉब्लम आ रही है ना हर बिजनेस में, दैट आई कैन रियली सॉल्व फॉर देम. सो आई नीड टू लिस्ट द 3 प्रॉब्लम्स आई एम सॉल्विंग. यू नो गाइस, सो इट्स अ वर्कशीट फॉर्मेट सेशन राइट नाउ. देयर्स अ, यू नो, यू नीड टू मेक अ नोट ऑफ दीज 12 फंडामेंटल्स एंड आंसर देम फॉर योर बिजनेस. यू विल हैव मोर फन डूइंग दैट. सो द फर्स्ट इज राइट डाउन द 3 प्रॉब्लम्स यू हैव, यू नो, पीपल हैव. And your business is a solution to that. Fundamental 2 is, what are their existing alternatives? आप ही दुनिया के नए अजूबे नहीं हो जो ये बेकिंग कर रहा है, right? There are thousands of bakers, thousands of makeup artists, thousands of jewelers doing the same thing. But how can you, so how are people now having existing alternatives? So if today, as a business coach, if today I know people are having problems of, you know, let's say they have no confidence to start a business. Like, that's a problem that I see most of the, you know, people have. And I can solve this problem. I can make you confident to start a business. Existing alternative kya hai isme? Log kya karte hain? In my case, log kuch karte hi nahi us bare mein. For 5 years, 10 years, they've only been thinking. करना है, कुछ करना है, कुछ करना है. अभी नहीं, अभी, यू नो, अभी शादी हुई, अभी बच्चे हुए हैं, अभी घर में शादी है, अभी ये है, वो है. दे हैव रीजंस एंड दे डोंट डू एनीथिंग, राइट? सो इट्स अ बिगर ट्रबल फॉर मी दैट फ्रॉम एग्जिस्टिंग ऑल्टरनेटिव उनके लिए लाइफ में कुछ है ही नहीं. ओके, इफ यू आर अ, से यू आर अ ज्वेलरी डिजाइनर और अ ज्वेलरी, यू नो, ब्रांड, फॉर यू एन एग्जिस्टिंग ऑल्टरनेटिव इज अ सिंपल कॉम्पिटिटर दैट दे विल गो टू समबडी एल्स एंड नॉट कम टू मी. At least imagine that person has the money to buy. So your problem is not that big. You just have to make sure that they come to you and not go to someone else. Right? So the second part in your business, you have to understand what is an existing alternative. If you really go dig deep, sometimes there are no existing alternatives. Sometimes it's just competitors. Sometimes it is something very random. Right? So that is the second part. Now the third part, the third fundamental is solution. So for each problem, you know, that you've written, the three top problems, I want you to write down three possible solutions that you are going to provide, and that's going to be different from any other brand. Okay, so a solution for a baker could be, oh, there are a lot of people who are lactose intolerant. They don't, they want to go vegan. So for the solution is, I'm only going to give them vegan food. Okay, as a baker, your other solution could be, there is a problem that there are nobody baking cakes for animals and cats and dogs. So the solution is, I'm going to be a pet cake baker or a pet food baker. I'm going to bake for pets. Another problem is, could be that there are people who are diabetic and they love sweets. So as a baker, I am going to create, food for diabetic, free eating food for diabetic people. So your possible solution could be anything. So identify the problem and list a possible solution for that particular problem. Okay, so for each problem, what is your specific solution? So look at that. Okay, the fourth point here is your customer segment. Okay, for your customer segment, all you got to do is list down your exact customers. Who are the exact people? And I'll tell you a funny story here. You know, when I started my mini MBA for startups, it's a 1 year long program. It's got, 30 hours of one-on-one coaching, 50 hours of group coaching, and many such things. So in total, you have about 90 hours of coaching in a year. Okay. I always thought, and it's an expensive program. So I always thought that, somebody who's new in business, somebody who's a startup, somebody who just wants to start a business will be my target audience. But I was wrong. It was really silly. But I realized that for this kind of money that I was charging for a 1 year mini MBA for startups, the people who were actually enrolling were the people who were already 5-10 years in business. You know, it was strange because I thought ke jo naya hoga usi ko meri zarurat hogi. But then I realized jo naya hai wo itna ded chana hai ke usko lagta hai mujhe ye karne ki zarurat nahi hai, meko pata hai kya karna hai. Aur unko ye tha ki, self doubt. That इतना पैसा मैं डाल रही हूँ, मेरे को तो श्योरिटी भी नहीं है मेरा बिजनेस चलेगा कि नहीं चलेगा. सो देयर वाज सेल्फ डाउट फॉर दीज न्यूबीज, एंड दैट्स व्हेन आई रियलाइज्ड दैट योर टारगेट ऑडियंस मे नॉट एग्जैक्टली बी द टारगेट ऑडियंस यू थिंक हू आर. यू नो, लॉट ऑफ माय क्लाइंट्स हैव दिस ऑडियंस व्हिच इज, दे से दैट हमारी ऑडियंस तो दीज वेरी हॉइटी टॉइटी वुमेन फ्रॉम रियली गुड रिच फैमिलीज होते हैं. And they are the ones who are our clients. And then after the research and whatever exercises we do, they realize that these people are actually not the clients. They are actually somebody jinke liye hum free kaam kar rahe. Practically free mein cheeze de rahe because they bargain so much with you. The real clients are the people who actually pay you. So you will really come to, you'll get aware that who your real audience is. You're probably not looking at your real audience. My real audience, at some point I thought, were these girls in the age group of 25, 30, just starting out of college. But that also changed. I realized my actual audience is any women who's in around 40s, 38 to 45 wala range. Bachche thode bade ho gaye hain, business thoda settle ho gaya hai, now very, very focused, wants to give the best shot and does not want to waste time. So, when you do these exercises with a coach, you really get clarity ke main to kuch aur hi soch rahi thi, main to kuch aur hi samajh rahi thi. So things change. So the fourth point that you need to address is, who are your customer segments? The fifth point is what I call as your early adopters. When you come up with a new product, with a new launch, with a new plan, with a new idea, who are the first set of people who immediately buy from you, who immediately adopt your plans? They are the ones you need to really know what they want. How can you, make sure that, they are actually, you're ahead of times with them. And they will actually go buy everything you sell. So I have certain students, they not only buy every session of mine, they also buy repeat sessions. And I actually go and tell them, 6 months back, you just did this session. Why are you doing it again? So they're like, no, we just want to revise. And I'm like, okay, great. I'm understanding that they are my early adopters. So now I keep them in my focus and I create more products for them. Right? So figure out who's your early adopters. That's the fifth point. The sixth point is your unique value proposition. Guys, the first 5 points, I really went extremely quick with you because somewhere, you know, I think because you are already in business, you kind of know. It's just that you've not put it down on paper. You've not verbally, you know, discussed this and thought about it, but you somewhere know these answers. The real question is now, which is the next point, which is the sixth point, which I call as the unique value proposition. A unique value proposition is your game changer. It is a single, clear, compelling message that states why you are different and worth paying attention for. You know, why should people give you attention? Why should people, you know, give you the bhav? Why should people actually, you know, consider you? This is where your point starts to move from failing. If you can figure out why people should pay you an attention. Okay. Now, simple ways to find your unique value proposition is, I'll give you an example here. You know, in 2009, I started as a brand consultant. And in 2009, people did not understand a shit of what a brand consultant means. Kisi ko samajhta hi nahi tha. You know, people didn't know. They're like, arre acha brand, karte kya ho aap? And it was so difficult to explain. I mean, I said, I create a brand. Acha, par wo kya hota hai? You know, it was like that. From a brand consultant, my unique value proposition changed into startup brand consultant. So I started calling myself, see, aapko business start karna hai na. So I will help you make your business into a brand. You know, making it professional, making have a correct logo, branding, you know, your website, everything. अच्छा 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 स्टार्टअप का करते हो इन 2009 गाइस स्टार्टअप कैसा नाम का कुछ था भी नहीं द होल स्टार्टअप गेम स्टार्टेड आफ्टर 2014 वी नोबडी अंडरस्टूड आई थिंक आई वाज वे अहेड ऑफ टाइम एंड आई स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग माय सेल्फ एज अ स्टार्टअप ब्रांड कंसल्टेंट देन ओवर इयर्स आई रियलाइज दैट ओके आई एम अ स्टार्टअप ब्रांड कंसल्टेंट फॉर 3-4 इयर्स इन 2015 आई रियलाइज आई वॉन्ट टू बी अ स्टार्टअप ब्रांड कंसल्टेंट फॉर वुमेन Because I got a lot of women in my business and they said, humko business start karna hai. Humara already kuch ghar se chal rahe hai. You know, people were selling bed sheets from home and they were approaching me to make their business better because social media had come in, digital was happening. So much was going on. They said, now we can really do something. Can you imagine? Pehle toh ghar mein hum chadre dikha ke bechte the. Now it's being sold online through Facebook groups. It's really unimaginable. But it happened. Right? At that point, I realized that there is a market here. These women are clueless. They need confidence. They need hand-holding. They need support. They need someone who, you know, whom they can speak to. They can discuss the idea with. And I wanted to become that person for them. So I became a startup business, you know, brand consultant for women. Now, in the last 1.5 years, I realized that this is also too broad. There is no unique value proposition here also. I can still create more unique value proposition. And so I then, you know, recreated this as a startup, a business coach for women solopreneurs. And guys, a simple question to ask, you know, when you want to find out your unique value proposition is, jaise aap kisi ko ye bolte ho na, uske man mein aana chahiye, are ye to meri baat kar rahi. The minute I say, you know, I'm a brand business coach for women solopreneurs. 50% of you are doing solo work. And your ears open up. Because you know that, are yaar, main solo hi to hoon. You know, I probably have 2 or 3, you know, karigars or those tune category people. You don't have a CEO or a marketing team or a HR team or an accounts team. You're actually solo. You are the chaprasi. You are everything in your business. The pune and the chaprasi, everything. So, the startup, you know, so that's how, if you want to figure out your unique value proposition, just close your eyes and say, what can you tell about your business that one-on-one people can, it can open up their ears. Are ye toh meri baat kar rahi. You know, so for example, now I'll tell you, you know, how big brands do it. Because I've worked with a lot of Fortune 500 brands. I've worked with HUL, P&G, I have worked with ICICI, many big brands, and this is the same formula everybody follows. So if let's take an example of Maggi. You know, what do people say that open up your ears to them? 2 minutes instant noodles. The minute, you know, instantly kuch khana hai, fatafat kya banna hai, you know, hassle free kya hai, ye bolte hi aapko aata hai ki chal Maggi khate hai. You know, so unique value proposition every brand has to have for them. You have to create something, one single message that sets you apart from others. You can be a baker, you can become a makeup artist, you can become a, you know, you can be a jeweler, you could be anything. But what could be that one thing about your business that can set you apart? I'll give you an example again here. I remember meeting a makeup artist and she said that, you know, I'm a makeup artist and I specialize. My unique value proposition is that I work very well with, you know, chubby faces, girls, you know, who have round face and plus size women, because they have a lot of limitations with hair and makeup and all of that. So I specialize with that. Now, apne kitno ke kaan khade ho jayenge, bhai kaun? Right? So that is how you can create your unique value proposition. You could be any in any business, right? So figure out your unique value proposition. That's the sixth point. Seventh is what, you know, the Lean Canvas model asks you is a high level concept. Okay. A high level concept in your business is something that when, you know, let's say you're a fashion designer. And let's say you're meeting me at a coffee shop, you know, or in this community, you know, 400 women, we randomly bump into an event. Now, the minute you know, you tell me, I tell you I'm a fashion designer, pehle to aap dekho ki maine pehna kya hai. Achha, khud ko fashion designer bol rahi, isne kya pehna hai? Right? Maybe that day I came from the gym. I just came the way I was, you know, I didn't dress up or anything. And then you say, "Acha, fashion designer. Okay, so what in fashion design? What do you do?" Right? Now, that's where your high-level concept plays a role. They cannot see what you've done. They don't know what you are doing. And you still have to explain them about, you know, about your business. A high-level concept is, for example, I would say, you know, most of the brands do that. Say, Zomato is TripAdvisor for restaurants. So what TripAdvisor does for hotels, same thing Zomato does for restaurants. That's a high level concept. You have compared your brand to any random high level brand so that people can totally relate. Kya ye kya karti hai? You know, so if you know, let's say you're a fashion designer, maybe you're doing, you know, plus size clothing. You could say that, I am the Manish Malhotra of plus size, which means I make those kind of high-end luxury, you know, embroidered, Indo-Western, whatever clothes, but for this audience, right? So that's your high-level concept. You are actually relating. Tea Villa Cafe said that I am Starbucks for teas, right? Totally apne dimag mein ek Starbucks ki image aayi. We totally understood ki agar ye Starbucks bol raha matlab ye kaisa space hoga, kaise tea serve hogi, kya experience milega, look and feel kaisa hoga. It was totally understandable. So that's a high level concept. You have to create a high level concept for your business so that it gets relatable to new fresh people. The eighth point here is called your unfair advantage. Okay, an unfair advantage is something that you don't get easily in your business. It takes about 5-10 years to achieve an unfair advantage. But an unfair advantage is something that cannot be easily bought or copied from your business. Aisa kuch aapke business mein jo koi copy nahi kar sakta. Okay, I'll give you an example. I have a client of mine in Bombay and she has, they are into, you know, it's a social enterprise. So what they do is they employ all these, you know, women from really down, you know, class community. They teach them tailoring. And tailoring karke, wo sirf ek hi cheez karte, they make instant wear saris. Okay, so there are two ways. You can either give your saris to them with your measurements. They will make an instant wear ready to wear sari for you, you know, or they have a set of saris that you can pick from, and from that they will make it an instant wear from you. The unfair advantage for this brand is they have filed and received a patent for this. And they say that we make instant wear saris and we have a patent of having an invisible pocket in that sari. So these saris come with pockets, and that's a patent. No one else can do it. It cannot be copied or bought, because if you do it, they can sue you. Right? So having a patent could be one of your unfair advantage. Okay. Sometimes a very good customer experience is an unfair advantage. Like a customer experience like a Mercedes and Audi can give you, nobody else can give you. You know, no other brand can give you. So that's an unfair advantage. Sometimes an unfair advantage is, you know, that you are actually targeting a very different set of market. You know, special children, doing something for them. You know, creating some products from them, you know, for them or through them. That could be also your unfair advantage. You know, to find your unfair advantage in your business, can aapko dimag diwar pe sar bhidana pad sakta hai. To ek do bar bhida lo, but crack this. You know, it will really be a game changer for you. The unfair advantage that I created for my business is, most of, you know, the existing alternatives or competitors are, for me, are these, you know, business schools. Jo women entrepreneurship courses karte hain, women entrepreneurship, you know, classes karte hain. The thing that gives me an unfair advantage is there, it is a group that they teach, and they teach theory, right? The unfair advantage that I do is I do one-on-one and I don't do theory. It is all practical. It is your business on the paper and your business, you know, seeing results every day. So that's an unfair advantage that I created. So for me, the unfair advantage is that I do a lot of one-on-one consulting and coaching. That cannot be easily bought or copied. Nobody can deliver exactly the way I will deliver a session or I will handle a client. So that's for me. Okay. The next is, which is the ninth one, is what I call as the cost structure. You know, most of us, especially women, have no, what do you call, tongue pooch of costings in business. क्योंकि आप घर में एक रूम में कर रहे हो तो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी घर की जा रही है, वो घर का छोटू है वो ही पैकिंग कर रहा है, और वो जो ऑफिस में हस्बैंड का प्यून है वो जाके डिलीवर कर रहा है, और घर में गाड़ी ड्राइवर है मैं उसमें जाके सामान लेके आती हूँ, तो मेरा घर कुछ लगता ही नहीं है ना, बस जो मेरा जो है बस वही लग रहा है. आपने अपना टाइम नहीं कैलकुलेट किया है, आपका आपके ये सारे कॉस्ट आपने कैलकुलेट नहीं किए हैं. Tomorrow, if you want to scale up, you know, why a Zara basic t-shirt is 4,000-5,000 rupees? Because they've put the cost structure in place. You are selling the same thing today for 1,000 rupees. And tomorrow you'll be like, are, mere paas to kuch bacha hi nahi. Mere paas to kuch tha hi nahi. You know, there's no, matlab, kitna hi kaam kar lo, kuch khud ke bank mein to ja hi nahi raha. Sab rolling ho raha hai. So that is because you have not put in a cost structure. Today it is your benefit that, you know, you have all these things at your disposal, but tomorrow it's not going to be the same. So you have to price yourself from today, and your pricing, most of the time your pricing is never right. You have really apne man se price kiya. Pricing strategy karke to hamare paas kuch formula hi nahi hai, right? So have a cost structure, figure out what, you know, what are the costs. You know, even if it's a plastic that you put your product in, that 1 rupee, 2 rupee plastic is also to be included, right? You have a paper bag. वो तो हमको याद भी नहीं रहता, वो 10 rupees की paper bag में भी भेज रही हूँ. एक एक outfit or whatever, you know, one thing. And you know, when I say this, I just said the message I was about to say, that the minute you say this pricing, you always have this, अरे but competitors भी तो हैं, उनको भी तो अपना pricing है. You think actually brands care about competitors? Because trust me, competitors are here to live forever for you. आज आप एक से प्राइस मैच करोगे, कल कोई उससे नीचे आएगा, परसों कोई उससे भी नीचे आएगा. यू नो वो एक्सपोर्ट सरप्लस तो 200-200 रुपए में भी कपड़े बेचते हैं. यू थिंक यू कैन डू दैट? सो कॉम्पिटिटिव प्राइसिंग हैज टू गेट आउट ऑफ द विंडो फॉर यू. सी, इट मे नॉट वर्क फॉर अ वेरी बिग ब्रांड लाइक एन HUL, बिकॉज दे आर डूइंग मास प्रोडक्शन, दे आर डूइंग मास सेलिंग, दे आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग इन मास. For them, competitor analysis is very important. For us, it is not important. Because understand, अगर आपके business में आपको सिर्फ 100 लोग दिन का business देते हैं, you have 100 people giving you business every day or every month, depending on what kind of business you are in. You know, if you get 100 makeup assignments every month, if you get 100 brides every month, if you get 100 bridal lehengas every month, if you get to sell 100 bridal jewelry every month, you just need 100 customers. And we are 130 billion people in India. आपको उसमें से सिर्फ 100 चाहिए. और वो 100 के लिए आपको competitor के बारे में सोचने की जरूरत ही नहीं. You know, go to different markets. Not every market will have your competitor. So stop worrying about competitors. This is the lamest excuse people give me. If I ask you, you know, you stay in a building, let's say you stay in a complex, that complex has 500 flats. If I ask you, do these all 500 people in those, you know, in each flat, every person in that flat knows what you do. Your business is set there only. If only those 500 people know what you do, it's great. It's doing well. But you will not worry about it. You will say, nahi, competition hai. Are, but aapki building mein to nahi hai. और अगर 500 लोग में से अगर 4 लोग भी करते हैं जो आप कर रहे हो, आप चारों को 100-100 लोग मिल जाए. जस्ट गेट योर 100 कस्टमर्स, राइट? सो कॉम्पिटिशन गाइज, स्टॉप वरिंग अबाउट कॉम्पिटिशन. इट इज ओनली टू बी वरिड फॉर बाय द बिगीज, जिसका मार्केट शेयर 50% ऑफ इंडिया है. देयर कॉम्पिटिशन विल मैटर, नॉट फॉर अस, राइट? कूल. So that is the cost structure. The 10th point is called as the revenue stream. Okay, that you need to figure out in your business, what is the revenue stream? How are we going to make money? Okay, and more than revenue stream, I would like to touch upon a new concept here. You know, a lot of people say job hi achha hai business se. You know, at least consistent income to hai. Chala, meri friend dekh, job kar rahi lakh rupaya mahine ka, idhar to 10-20,000 mein hamara kuch ठिकाना नहीं है. यू नो, आया नहीं आया. इट इज सो नॉट कंसिस्टेंट, राइट? बट यू नो व्हाट गाइस, लॉजिकली थिंक, आवर पेरेंट्स, आवर फैमिली, आवर फादर्स, वी ऑल आर 90% पीपल आर मारवाड़ीज हियर. आई एम ऑल्सो अ महेश्वरी, सो आई एम एंजॉइंग दिस स्पेस ऑल्सो. बट अंडरस्टैंड, आवर फैमिलीज डिड बिजनेस, उनने जॉब क्यों नहीं किया? Because they knew that this business is going to be scalable. Job mein toh ek hi lakh milega, yahan se hum ek ka 10 kar sakte hain. First thing. Second thing, you know, our families run on the family business. Matlab wo har mahine ka jo kharcha hai na, wo us business se aata hai. So logically think that that business has to consistently do business every month. They can't do is mahina 10,000, agle mahina 10 lakh, nahi kar sakte, unko ghar chalana hai. So the model that our families have actually incorporated is a recurring revenue model, which humne to usko dur dur tak socha hi nahi hai. What can you do in your business that can give you recurring revenue every month? Har mahina aapko 1 lakh rupees is fixed. Fir uske upar jitna aayega uski mehnat alag karni padegi aapko. This is how our families have been doing business. Their recurring income has been in place. It is set. But that is something that we've not even thought about. We have to think about a recurring revenue. And the reason I always say that, you know, people say that business better or job better, and then they say nahi, business hi better, humko to yehi karna, aur fir rote rehte hain. It's not working out. The point is, you've not created these 12 fundamentals in your business. This fundamental of having a recurring revenue has to be planned. You know, and you can actually work towards it. आप एक B2B का project ले लो. अगर आप एक baker हो तो एक set of restaurants का tie up कर लो कि every month इतने pieces तो मैं इधर भेज ही रही हूँ, फिर कोई केक का ऑर्डर आया कुछ अलग है तो वो मेरा एडिशनल है, बट माय रेगुलर बिजनेस इज सेट, विच इज एग्जैक्टली नॉट फार, इट इज फार फ्रॉम वेयर वी आर इवन स्टैंडिंग. सो ओपन योर वेज टू व्हाट यू कैन डू टू क्रिएट रेकरिंग रेवेन्यू इन योर बिजनेस, राइट? सो दैट्स अनदर थिंग. एंड 11th पॉइंट इज योर की मैट्रिक्स. ओके, इन एवरी बिजनेस there is something called as key matrix. These are key numbers that decide whether your business is successful or not. If I actually ask you, you know, how much money did you make in the last 1 year, you don't know. Nobody knows. Kuch pata hi nahi hai. Ek random hai. Haan, theek hai, ye aaya hua hai. But exact, ke 5,25,760 rupees I made. Nobody can give that figure. You think big brands can give that? Yes, they can. Why can we not give it? Because we don't have key numbers. First, second thing, anybody you ask na, deep down main aapko puchu na aapka business kaise kar raha hai, mere muh pe aap bologe ha theek chal raha hai, but deep down you are unhappy with your business. You're absolutely unhappy. You think you have failed, you think the business doesn't do well. Somewhere you want to give up, but ijjat ki baat hai to band bhi nahi karna hai. And the reason I always, you know, I say this is because you don't have your key numbers in place. Set your key numbers in business. That if I do one bride a week, I am successful. You're doing that much. You know, you're doing that as a makeup artist, but you're not happy about it because aapko pata hi nahi aapko chahiye kya. Key numbers is setting your target right. So let's say, you know, if you're a jewelry designer, so give yourself that I need to do 5 lakh rupees of business every month. Then break it down. Khali 5 lakh rupees bol ke nahi chalega. 5 lakh mein se mujhe 20,000 ki, I'm just giving you random stuff right now. 20,000 ka kuch aata nahi hai. But 20,000 ki mujhe rings bechni hai. Kyunki wo easy hogi. 5 ring meri bikni chahiye. 5 earrings mere bikne chahiye, you know, itne itne amount ke. Break your key matrix. You know, for me, it is like I need to have this many numbers of mini MBA for startups. I need to have this many people enrolling for my startup masterclass. I have these many people to buy my workbook. You know, I have a Start Your Business workbook. It's an ebook for $4.99. If you want a hard copy, it's $14.99. So I am very clear that itni ebooks bikni chahiye, itni workbook bikni chahiye. Yahi to plan banta hai na. Then I work towards it. Ki acha meri ebooks 50 hi biki hai, mujhe 100 chahiye, to aur 50 ke liye mujhe mehnat karni hai. At least I have direction, mujhe mehnat kahan karni hai. Right now we are all stuck cribbing and not working in any direction. Right? So key matrix is your key numbers. And it is a clear number that tells you that, you know, how well your business is doing. So you need to figure out your numbers, right? And the last, which is the 12th fundamental of making sure your business does not fail, is what I call as channels. You know, aapne apne man mein apne business ka sab bana liya hai. मेरा यूनिक वैल्यू प्रोपोजिशन ये है, मेरा अनफेयर एडवांटेज ये है, ये मेरा ऑडियंस है, ये मेरा कॉस्ट है, ये मेरा रेवेन्यू है, ये मेरे की मैट्रिक्स है, बट नोबडी इन द वर्ल्ड नोज यू दैट यू एग्जिस्ट ऑल्सो, ऐसा कोई ब्रांड भी है. सो चैनल्स इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट इन मेकिंग श्योर योर बिजनेस डज नॉट फेल. इज वॉट इज योर पाथ टू योर कस्टमर्स. यू नो, इफ यू वॉक डाउन योर रोड, every store there will give you a thumbs up, it will give you a Pepsi, it will give you your Lays. That is the channel, that is the path to the customer. You know, most of the time people don't even know where to see your product. They can't even see it. You've not even placed your products in stores or even made a great photo shoot about your product and put it up on social media or on the website. Nahi, log meri idea chori kar lenge, mujhe nahi dalna hai. I don't want people to see my work. You know, let them come to me. So what is your channel? Where will people see what you do? You know, are you associated with multi-designer stores so that more and more people can know about your fashion label? Are you, very, very active on social media that people can actually, know about your products? are you active in networking events? You know, a lot of people, when they go to a networking event, they may be going every event, but nobody knows them yet. Ki dikhti hai, par ye kaun hai, kya karti hai, we don't know. So your channel, maybe, you know, maybe for someone like me, a good channel at a point was networking events. But I would go there and I would stand, you know, saying that, वो इंट्रोडक्शन राउंड होता है, आई विल इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ, हो गया काम मेरा, मैं ये करती हूँ, दो लाइन में बोल दूंगी. बट इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट, इट इज द एफर्ट्स आई एम पुटिंग, मेकिंग श्योर ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन गेट्स 10 मिनट्स फॉर मी टू स्पीक. दैट्स माय चैनल, दैट्स वेयर आई कलेक्ट द ईमेल्स, द एड्रेसेस, द फोन नंबर्स, आई कम बैक, आई टॉक टू देम, आई कन्वर्ट देम, आई स्पीक टू देम. सो ऑल दिस प्रोसेस वी हैव गॉन थ्रू. व्हाट इज योर चैनल, हाउ विल पीपल सी you and your product, right? So this was a quick 45 minutes conversations into, you know, giving you as to what all elements you need to incorporate in your business, making sure it does not fail, right? So that's it from me. If there's anybody having any questions, I think we'll be open for them, and then Kavita, you can definitely take over now.
So if anyone has any question, you can raise your hand.
I have a question. May I go ahead?
Yes, yes, Anupriya.
Yes. Also, Nishita.
Yes.
See, a lot of us over here on Cafe are women over 30, even over 40. And it's the first time that we may be looking at starting our own business. So some of us have worked earlier, some of us have never worked. And starting a business is no joke, right? It takes time. So what is the time frame that we should look at before we can say, I give up now, I can't carry it anymore? What is the minimum time frame? Through your experience, what does your experience?
I'll tell you what, if you are in a business in the first 6 months, you should give up. You should not wait. Because in the first 6 months, you'll understand. If you've given your 100%, in the first 6 months, you will know what is not working out for you. And I'll give you an example here. I have also given up on businesses. Okay. So I'll give you an example. I'm a brand consultant, business coach for the last 11 years now. In 2016, I had this passion in my mind that I wanted to launch a plus size designer wear label for plus size women. Okay. And, you know, I was very sure branding, marketing, I'll take care of. I know what to do, you know, how it is to be done. I'm very sure. I have a very good sense of styling and a sense of, you know, dressing up and all that. People look up to me. So that also, I was like that I will bring in my taste, my style of dressing, you know, for plus size women, and they appreciate me and they, you know, aspire watching me. So it'll do fine. When I launched the brand, I launched it in a Times Fashion Week as a label. I was on the RAM. My brands were, my collection was on there. That's the launch, how I did it, because I was very clear in my head what I want to do with this brand. I had a celebrity showstopper. I paid her a bomb to be my celebrity showstopper. If you all know, if you all have watched this Mahi Ve karke series aata tha, Pushti Shakti karke, there was this girl who's chubby and all that. She was the showstopper. So it was all very well. Everything went off very well. In 6 months to 8 months time, I realized that I am not doing right with my costings. My products are becoming expensive because I had hired a team of designers and then a team of, you know, workshop with karigars. And I realized that marketing, branding, I'm good at. But one thing that I'm not good at is getting the costings in place so that my product, final product is right, you know, priced right. Costing was a problem. Second thing, what was a problem was that I had made a collection of, you know, for plus size women of, you know, evening shirts, lunch and dinner shirts that you could wear, you know, with embroideries and all that over pants. And my age group was very clear, 30, 35 plus women, you know, who are not very, you know, jinko thoda dressy dress up hona hai. They cannot wear something from, you know, All or Amidas and all that. They need very good clothing and they can spend also. My clothes were priced between 5 to 15,000 rupees. Everything was well done. But these two problems that I made shirts and selling a shirt for 8,000-9,000 rupees, nobody was paying that much money. Okay. वही शर्ट्स के कुछ पीसेस मैंने लॉन्ग कर दिए थे, नी लेंथ कर दिए थे, एंड दोज वर सेलिंग फॉर 15,000 रुपीज. ऑल ऑफ दैट गॉट सोल्ड जस्ट बिकॉज माई लेंथ ऑफ माई आउटफिट वॉज लॉन्गर. दे कुड सी द वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट. 15,000 में मुझे वन पीस ड्रेस मिल रही है या लॉन्ग ड्रेस मिल रही है. ओके टू स्पेंड सो मच. इमेजिन वो नीचे तो कुछ काम भी नहीं था, सारा काम तो ऊपर ही था, सिर्फ लेंथ बढ़ा दी थी हमने. And those pieces I was selling for 15,000 rupees. Everything sold out. Mere khud ke liye bhi ek bhi piece nahi bacha. Okay. And this, you know, range of 7, 8, 9.
But Nishita, I'm sorry. So what you're talking about is like going all out with your brand or your operations, business operations, right? This scenario of considering 6 months time, giving yourself 6 months time is going all out.
Going all out.
But yeah, but members here in cafe, we are a different peculiar scenario. We are doing a lot of juggling and each one of us is taking smaller steps. We may not be able to go 100%. So in that case, do you suggest that no, going all out is the only way? Or if we are taking slow, if we are taking things a little slower because we are scared also, if we are taking things a little slower, then we could expand this timeline to a year or 2 years. What is that maximum timeline when we are going very slow and conservative?
See, when you say very slow and conservative, you know, it only means that you have small budgets.
No, I have time limitations. I seriously have time limitations. I have 2 young kids who I do not want to leave to the maids or my mother-in-law. So I can spare only 4 hours every day to my work. 4 hours is a very optimistic time that I can spend every day. So what is the timeline then?
In a situation like for you, you don't have a choice to give up. You either do it or you don't do it. There is no giving up in this. See, if you're not giving your 100%, then when will you give up?
Understand? That's what I'm asking. So if I'm not... Give up
because you deep down, you know it. 3-4 ghanta de rahi hu, main itna hi time de pa rahi hu. So jitna result aa raha hai, usme aap khush rehna seekh lo.
Haan, so nahi, par usme bhi profitability ya break-even ke liye kuch to timeline hona chahiye na, ki I'm doing something right or wrong.
Usme strategy honi chahiye. Timeline नहीं
होनी चाहिए, strategy होनी चाहिए.
क्योंकि understand, if you're working 4 hours a day, I'll tell you very right. honestly. Right now. Mm-hmm. Before I was married, I was working from 6 in the morning to 8 in the night. I was not married.
Right.
Then
right.
I got married. I got into a joint family. My time at today, as on today, is 2 to 7. Because I have the entire day to one to myself, my health, my family, my husband, everything. मेरे पास 2 to 7 ही है. I clearly know I have 5 hours a day to work. And my strategy is very clear. Recurring revenue kitna aa raha hai isme mujhe. Wo mera optimum kitna hona chahiye. Mujhe wohi strategy banani hai. If you know, spending 4 hours a day, working 6 days a week, giving Sunday off, you're spending how much?
24 hours a week.
So you're almost spending 100 hours a month. To work 100 hours, if you're getting 1 lakh rupee, you should be happy.
So right. Yes, so that's a difference of strategy, right? So it changes with circumstance to circumstance. That will change, right? Yes, I just needed that validation. That's it. Thank you.
There's no timeline. You will. Aap kabhi give up kar hi nahi paoge because somewhere deep down you will be guilty that I'm not doing enough. How can I give up? That way. So you cannot, you know, give up in that timeline.
So all to all the ladies here, I would just like to say that giving up is not an option. Even if you're going slow and things are not working out for you and for me, giving up is not an option. So this is just a reinstatement of our philosophy at Cafe.
Yes.
Never an option.
Nishita, there's a question that, you know, any message or any specific point if we are talking about services only and not products?
Services is my favorite thing because I'm also into a service. You know, I think I master into services than products. It's just that it's an audience of women, so I use a lot of examples with that.
Yeah.
But even if it is a service and you're looking at any specific thing to keep in mind, but the services are intangible. You cannot see them, right? That's why you cannot even put a price tag on them. Okay, when I was designing logos, when I started off with, you know, the first logo that I did for someone, it was for 3,000 rupees, you know, logo, stationery and all that, you know, 2018, you know, we started doing a lot of international brands and all that. We started charging 125,000 for the same thing. And I think I was using the same mind, you know, it was just... because there's no price tag. It is all about the value you create in this. So if you're selling a service, guys, list down, you know, I call it some in my workbook also, you know, you can definitely go ahead and buy the workbook. It's about 160 pages, 25 modules. All I've done is how big brands like HUL and all that work towards creating a brand. You know, what are the things they do? It's a workbook. There are exercises. You can just sit, you know, with your tea and coffee and just start filling it up. All your answers, questions will be answered. Coming back to this point of this, that there is a topic there, which I call as your clear list of deliverables. CLD is what I call. If you're in a service, just keep writing down precisely what are the clear list of deliverables in your business. Because wahi logo ko dikhega. Aur wahi jab dikhega, to log aapko, you know, kya bolte hain? You know, I'll give you a very simple example. You know, who decides how much money you're supposed to pay to your maids and cook? It's a service. It's intangible. You don't even know how well they're doing it.
True.
Right? But you know, there is a market price that isse zyada koi deta nahi hai. Isse koi manega nahi. There is a market price. Right? But we are not maids. Right, so that's energy exchange. कि झाड़ू करेगी तो उसके सामने उसको पैसा मिलेगा. पोता करेगी उसके सामने उसको पैसा मिलेगा. That is energy exchange. People, we still work in the mindset of exchange. Money is just a medium, right? Ultimately, we need the value. And I'll give another example. Knowledge exchange भी एक exchange होता है. तो पैसा आप आपके lawyers को, CA को, doctor को और शादी वाले पंडित को देते हो ना, वो knowledge exchange में देते हो. You fucking don't know वो मंत्र में क्या बोल रहा है. You don't know what the laws are. You don't know the terminologies of a doctor. What jo bole wo sahi. Right? So that is knowledge exchange. That's that, in that way, there are 5 exchanges that we do. And money is just a medium. So in service, what you have to figure out is your exchange. So the best example to do that is have your CLD in place, a clear list of deliverables. Right? Guys, one more thing. You know, there are 40-50 of you all here. I'm sure you all will have a lot of questions. 50% of you all will be like, mereko group mein nahi puchna hai, mujhe one-on-one mein puchna hai. I am offering a 30-minute session, one-on-one. You all can book at 500 rupees or a 60-minute session at 1,000 rupees. It's just the lockdown. A lot of people wanted to speak to me. So this is something that I'm offering. If any one of you is interested, you all can DM me on Instagram or you can get in touch with Kavita and, you know,
I'll share the details of yours.
Yeah. So in any case, anybody wants to, you know, connect on a one-on-one.
Nishita, I wanted to ask one thing. I'm into the decor, platter, wedding things, torso packing sort of things. So what I have done, when I started with few things, you know, then I kept on adding many things to it. Now what is happening when someone is asking me, what are you into exactly? So I got this many things. Whatever someone wants, I have got that thing. So in that way, I'm in a benefit that whatever something or other is going on, like kabhi anniversary hai, kabhi birthday hai, kabhi ganpati hai, kabhi rakhi hai, to mere ko alag-alag section ka work to mil jata hai. Lekin usme kya hota hai? Overall, mujhe apne aap ko ek compact, smart way mein present karne mein kai baar takleef hoti hai. Ki what exactly Naisha belongs to, because I am into so many things and everything is going on fine. Matlab kabhi kisi cheez ka season hai, kabhi kisi cheez ka season hai. Aur ye aisa nahi ki it's not working, it's working. But ek presentation wise, mujhe lagta hai ki kai baar wo clumsy ho jata hai. So should I reduce my work or I should go on like this only?
No, I'll tell you what you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
You know, when I say I'm a business coach for women solopreneurs, अगर आपको अंदर की बात बोलूं, मैं ये नहीं करती हूँ, सिर्फ ये नहीं करती हूँ.
ओके,
आई थिंक हाफ ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग माई आंसर. आई डोंट डू दिस, आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू बी नोन फॉर डूइंग दिस. सो आपके बिजनेस में गेट नोन फॉर डूइंग वन थिंग. तो क्या अगर लोगों को आपका रिकॉल, जो मैंने स्टार्टिंग में बोला था ना कि इंडस्ट्री आई और आपका रिकॉल हुआ, राइट? तो बी नोन फॉर डूइंग वन थिंग. आप खुद सोचो, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू बी नोन फॉर, एंड द अदर थिंग्स पीपल नो यू, राइट? आफ्टर दे नो यू, दे विल कम एंड बाय एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम यू. सो आई विल टेल यू व्हाट आई डू. आई डू सेल्स ट्रेनिंग फॉर ब्रांड्स लाइक गुची एंड एलवी, बट आई डोंट वांट टू बी नोन एज अ सेल्स ट्रेनर. आई डू यू नो branding and marketing outsourced consultation for many brands which are not owned by women, they're owned by men, but I don't want to be known for that kyunki udhar bahut competition hai. Main wo bolne lag jaungi to meko, you know, nobody will know me. So I do many things, but this is what I want to be known.
मैं एक प्रोफाइल स्ट्रक्चर है मुझे बना लेना होगा, एंड उसके अलावा साइड बाय साइड जो लोग मेरे कॉन्टेक्ट में आएंगे उनको पता कि ये भी अवेलेबल है, वो भी अवेलेबल है.
Absolutely. Okay. Be known for one.
Thank you. Nishita, I have a question. I really resonated at the point when you said ki sab ghar se kar rahe hain aur ghar ka chhotu bhi bhag raha hai aur driver kar raha hai, and you know, we are using all these services.
Right.
Suniti, we can't hear you anymore. Hello? I think there is some connectivity issue at her end.
Okay, is it better now?
Yes,
Suniti.
Yeah. So I was saying that I do agree that we are using intangible services at our end. But then any tips on how we, you know, proceed with this, or what's the solution?
See, there is no solution. You are lucky you have these services, you know, that you can use for free. So enjoy them. But what my point was that in your costings, include those as a cost.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So for example, if your chhotu is a salary of 10K, you know, and if you had to hire a chhotu for your work, include that 10K in your cost. Okay, mera kharcha hai. You know, all I'm saying is include it. See, it's obviously to your benefit right now. You're lucky to, you know, have a chhotu for free.
Mm-hmm.
But the point is that if you include that in your costing, your pricing will get better. And my point is that go in the market with that price. Because aage jaake aapko sirf ghar ke chhotu se kaam nahi karna. I'm sure you want to scale up. You want to have an office. You want to have a workshop of your own. So if you don't plan it now, it'll never happen for you.
Yeah. And any tips on how to increase the costs with existing clients? I mean, when is a good time to kind of scale up and say that, listen, we are revising our fee structure in terms of services?
So I'll tell you what, you know, when you immediately go and tell a client, no, that abhi ye abhi 100 ka tha, ab 200 ka ho gaya, they get very irritated and they don't like it. Like, नहीं मेरे को तो 100 में ही करके दो, you know, all that happens. You have to create a teaser. You have to create it as a buzz. You know, every year in April, my consultation fees also increases. तो वो लोगों को मैंने एक साल पहले से ही बोल दिया होता है कि अभी अप्रैल से मेरा चेंज होने वाला है प्राइसिंग. एंड पीपल नो इट नाउ. पीपल हु नो मी वेल विल नो इट. एवरी अप्रैल चेंज. सो यू हैव टू टीज देम इनटू इट. Not now, but you'll see that from, you know, abhi April se I'm going to revise my prices. April se I'm going to revise my prices. Aap abhi se bolna shuru karo, April mein aap revise karoge, to it'll sink in with them.
All right.
I have a question.
Yeah, Devika.
Like, I make handmade products. So, like, as you said, ki electricity ka, chhotu ka, car ka, वो एड नहीं करके बेसिक प्रोडक्ट का ही अगर प्राइसिंग करते पीपल से, ओ ये तो हाथ से बना हुआ घर का है तो इतना प्राइसिंग क्यों?
कोई ऐसे बोले ना, आप अपना प्रोडक्ट उनसे ले लो और बोलो बाय बाय, आई एम नॉट गिविंग यू.
लाइक पीपल एक्चुअली ना एग्जीबिशन में, अरे ये तो हाथ का चीज है इतना प्राइसिंग क्यों, बिकॉज वी आर गिविंग स्टॉल का भी रेंटल एंड एवरीथिंग.
हियर यू नीड टू वर्क ऑन योर वैल्यू सिस्टम. that Devika has made something and it is valuable. The minute you think that way and the way you present yourself, nobody should even question you. You know, and I'll give you an example. I have my own best friend, close friend. She makes, you know, not real jewelry, all those, you know, funky stuff, malas and all that. Her each mala is like 10, 20 grand. Okay, main apni khud ki best friend se bargain nahi kar pati. Because the way she presents me her products, the way she laid down on the table, even for me, the way she, you know, presented to me, I mujhe khud ko sharam aa jati ki isko main bolungi ki, you know, thoda sasta kar de, to ye mere bare mein kya sochegi? Ki Nishtha to gareeb hai, you know, like that way. So you have to present your product to them in such a way. And I'll give you another example. I went to a store in Switzerland, watch store. वो लोग हाथ में ग्लव्स पहन के वेलवेट ग्लव्स पहन के हमको घड़ियां दिखा रहे थे. मेरे को तो घड़ी टच करने को भी डर लग रहा था. Because he was presenting it that way, you know.
Yeah.
So the point is, Devika, you have to first create value for your own product. And आप अपने माइंड में होगे ना कि मेरा प्रोडक्ट तो भाई महंगा ही है. लेना है तो लो, नहीं तो जाओ. और आप, मैं आपको सच्ची बता दूं, विमेन बाय नेचर आपसे बार्गेन करने ही वाले हैं. By nature, it is even I will come and buy for you. एक तो try मारूंगी मैं भी. कुछ कम हो सकता है क्या? I will do it. You know, it is the way you present to me, not offending me, but presenting it to me in such a way that I will not dare to ask you. And this is possible. I do a lot of sales and marketing training, and I train you to do this. It is really possible to keep stay on your price.
Thank you.
Fantastic, Nishita. Thank you for giving your time. I will now request our Karnataka chapter leader, Bhavika, to give the final vote of thanks.
Hi, Nishita. It was an amazing session. Your one-liners, your punch, it made so lively the session, and we had so much takeaway, like really, really, really great help to each and every one of us here in the cafe. Sure, this will help all of us who are in this business or small entrepreneurs, solo entrepreneurs. Definitely, we have taken so much today back. We have learned so much. Your 11 points, they were amazing. 12 points, yes, sorry. So I have made a note of that. I can share with them in the group if anyone has missed out. But amazing session, Nishita. Great to know you as a person.
Yeah, right. And I will also vouch for her worksheet book, which I have also purchased. And it's actually, you know, very simple worksheet book, but, you know, very like, it's like a hands-on thing for you. Whatever it's there in your mind, it's there in the book, and you just need to write the answers. So everybody can go and, you know, visit her profile on Insta, and you will find all the details of about her services there. And that's also wonderfully put, Nishita, on the Insta thing. So
thank you so much. I teach how you can do it for your business as well.
Wow. So
I will definitely take it. And I have one small question if the time allows.
Yeah, Nishita?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So like, I myself am a graphic designer, and I have a big problem when it comes to a friends and family who do work, for whom I do the work, and asking the payment part. That's a big problem which I always face. So initially what I've done is strategy, I make a PDF of my billing and I send pehle hi. But then after the work is done, I'm like, I just don't know, clueless how to again go and ask for my work which I've done.
That's a really big problem. I'm Shweta, I'm also a graphic designer. That's a really big problem actually. If it is only costing around 400-450 और आपने 5-7 जनों का काम किया, 10 जनों का भी काम किया आपके लिए, तो वो 4-5 grand हो गया ना, 4-5 thousand. तो फिर एक जन के लिए तो काट रही है, तो वो मांगने में भी कैसे लगता है. बट मेरे को बोलना पड़ा है, आपके लिए होगा, मेरे लिए तो बहुत सारा है, आपको देना तो दे देंगे तो बढ़िया रहेगा. आई विल बी ऑनर्ड इफ आई रिसीव माय पेमेंट.
So I'll tell you what happens. You know, this question has come to me in every session. Okay. then it's a big problem. It was not only for you, it was for me also when I started. Because when we start, then friends or family is our first audience. Hota hai. Right? And वो लोग भी बोलते हैं हाँ तो शुरू करना हम लोग सब तेरे से लेंगे यू नो ऑफिस से भाग जाते हैं एवरीबॉडी विल एक्सपीरियंस दिस सो ओवर टाइम आई केम अप विद दिस प्लान एंड स्ट्रेटजी एंड आई मेक श्योर ऑल माय क्लाइंट्स आल्सो डू दिस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आप या तो उनको फ्री में कर दो अगर आप कर सकते हो तो अपने बिजनेस में बिकॉज दे विल बिकम योर ब्रांड एडवोकेट्स इफ यू कैन डू इट फॉर देम इन योर बिजनेस यू नो For me to give an e-book to my friend and family is doable क्योंकि वो e-book है मुझे कोई cost नहीं है तो मैं वो free में दे सकती हूँ और मैं देती भी हूँ friends and family को but if it is a hard copy भाई मेरा printing का तो पैसा लगा है ना वो कोई सस्ता नहीं था मेरा printing भी 500 रुपया है it's not cheap right and इतना तो मुझे भी चाहिए so you know very clearly for my workshop sessions because I used to do at 5 stars book hotels per person cost food cost You know, all that is there. So what I did was I created a friends and family package. So for example, if you have, you know, you are my friend and I would say, you know, you say, Nishita, mereko tera workshop karna hai. Tabhi bolne ko bhi ke bhai tujhe paise dene padenge, wo bhi sharam aati hai.
Haan.
You know, because workshop hai, toh usme tera kya kharcha laga? Tu toh bol hi rahi hai na. Tera koi product thodi hai. You know, all these stupid things happen.
Yeah, yeah.
I clearly tell them. I said, you know what? My workshop is, for example, it is at 10,000 rupees. My friends and family package is 7,500.
I do that for different. It's like 2,500 for them. I make it 1,850, but then also that 1,850 doesn't come in.
Yeah, so correct. That's something. Step one first is have your friends and family pricing, and the next thing is then don't indulge yourself in collecting the payment.
Okay.
Get somebody to call them and ask for it.
Okay.
Like an assistant. अभी आपके पास असिस्टेंट नहीं होगा क्योंकि इतना बड़ा ऑफिस थोड़ी लेके बैठे हैं कोई झूठा मूठा असिस्टेंट बनाओ फ्रेंड को जो आपके हर फैमिली और फ्रेंड को कॉल करके आपका पेमेंट कलेक्ट करेगी आई एम कॉलिंग फ्रॉम भाविकास टीम ये वो फिर उसने कैसे भी मांगा हो अगर कोई आता मेरी टीम में ऐसे बात की आपसे अभी मैं देखती हूँ उसको तो समटाइम्स विद
पर्सनल फैमिली दैट्स अ गुड आईडिया इंपैक्ट
मैं पहले नहीं मांगती थी लेकिन अभी मैं व्हाट्सएप करती हूँ अ जेंटल रिमाइंडर इन केस यू फॉरगॉट करके आई जस्ट सेंड माय बिल बिकॉज सारे फैमिली के लोग तो ग्रांटेड लेके ही बैठे हैं मुझे कि एग्जीबिशन होगा ये दे देगी तो वो अब मुश्किल हो गया था मेरे लिए तो आई हैव स्टार्टेड डूइंग दिस तो अब उन्हें पता है पैसे देने होंगे तो अब वो देते हैं पहले मुश्किल था लेकिन अब देते हैं वो लोग
बट द सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्मल वे इज टू गेट अ टीम टू डू इट इवन आई कुड नॉट आस्क फॉर मनी आई गॉट अ गर्ल Who was my friend, and I used to tell her, "Okay, bhai, call this person and ask for payment."
No, I like that idea, and it will give a good impact. Ke, haan, achha, team we man.
This is a very good idea. Exactly, I'll also follow it.
Yeah, thank you so much, Nishita. It was pleasure.
Fantastic, Nishita. Very, very nice. I'm sure we all have benefited, and we'll keep benefiting from your forthcoming sessions and your workshops, which we all will like to join. So,
great. Let me share my Insta handle. I'll say, give you the link on your group. At least let everybody follow me.
Yes.
Because I put a lot of 1 minute videos. I have an IGTV channel, which has about 30-40 1 hour sessions.
Oh, wow.
So even if you don't take anything paid from me, you can just hear those sessions. There are specific topics on sales and marketing. It'll really benefit you all. And let's stay in touch on Instagram.
Absolutely. Yep.
All
thank right. you. Thank you so much, Nishita. Bye-bye. Bye, everyone.
Bye.